Did you know that cybersecurity is one of the most in-demand fields in today's labor market? There simply aren't enough qualified professionals to fill all the vacancies. Now, if you have a background in software development, systems administration, or networking, you are in a good position to make the leap. But what if you are working in a completely different field? Perhaps you aren't tech-savvy, but you find computers intriguing nonetheless. You also can make the leap, if you are willing to put in the time and effort. Cybersecurity is a vast field with various disciplines, each requiring a unique set of technical skills and knowledge. Red teamers break into systems using techniques resembling those of real-world attackers in order to find vulnerabilities before they are exploited by others. Blue teaming is the opposite. It is all about detecting and preventing threats. Digital forensics and incident response, on the other hand, are about investigating and responding to breaches that have already occurred. The internet is filled with great resources free of charge, but the information is scattered and difficult to piece together. You may quickly get overwhelmed, not knowing where to begin or what exactly you should study. The SANS Institute is the most trusted resource for cybersecurity training and certifications. SEC504, Hacker Tools, Techniques, and Incident Handling is a 6-day course that lays a solid foundation upon which to build your cybersecurity career. The first day introduces students to the field of incident response and digital investigations. You will learn about important principles such as the chain of custody and the order of evidence volatility. You will dive into fascinating topics such as live Windows examinations, network, memory, malware, and cloud investigations, in addition to a primer on the Linux operating system. Day 2 focuses on pre-exploitation activities. Open source intelligence can be leveraged by attackers and defenders alike. DNS reconnaissance can provide valuable information to threat actors about a specific organization. Host discovery and assessment using Nmap is a common method of performing network mapping. The day concludes with a study on Windows Server message block session attacks. The third day is all about initial access and gaining a foothold through password attacks. Instead of trying to compromise a system through malware or living of the land binaries and scripts, password attacks provide a more reliable means of bypassing defenses. Tools such as Hydra, John the Ripper, Hashcat, and Netcat will become very familiar by the end of the day. Day 4 is a deep dive into exploitation frameworks and web application attacks. You will gain hands-on experience using the Metasploit framework to identify vulnerabilities that can be exploited. Attacks such as command injection, cross-site scripting, SQL injection, and server-side request forgery will be addressed as well. The defense spotlight is reserved for the Windows System Resource Usage Monitor, which provides a wealth of diagnostic data for incident responders and forensic analysts. The fifth day will keep you on the edge of your seat. It's all about post-exploitation activities, such as pivoting and lateral movement, as well as defense evasion through ghostwriting and software signing. Moreover, you will learn how attackers establish persistence on a compromised host, and how they cover their tracks on the network. By the end of the day, you will know how to detect patterns of beaconing activity and understand how DNS tunneling works. The final day of the course is a Capture the Flag event. It is a tremendously exciting day. The class will be split into teams of 3 or 4 pupils. In order for you to win, you must put your best foot forward and cooperate well with your team. The members of the winning team will receive the sought-after SEC504 challenge coin. Personally, I think SEC504 lays a solid foundation of the basic concepts of cybersecurity. Students are provided the course materials in physical and electronic formats, along with a great set of lab exercises accompanied by in-depth instructions. Since the lab environment is provided as virtual machines, students essentially have a lifetime access to the training grounds. This is spectacular because many other training providers place strict time limits on lab access. Regarding the GIAC Certified Incident Handler certification exam, this is what you should know. The exam consists of a theoretical assessment as well as a number of practical lab exercises. The format is open book, with multiple choice questions, and the time limit is 214 minutes. In order for you to get a high passing score, you will need to spend considerable time crafting a detailed index. Although the exam is open book, you have a very limited amount of time to find the answers. Also, be prepared to allocate at the very least 1 hour for the lab exercises. GIAC certifications are highly regarded in the cybersecurity industry, and many job offers nowadays require at least one of them. So, why wait any longer? Acquire the relevant skills for the cybersecurity field. Visit sans.org and preview the SEC504 course. If you need a justification letter for your employer, you can get one as well. All the best in your endeavors.